Hello and welcome, Gemini. This is your July 2023 reading. And what we do here is we will look at the, we will separate the reading into sections so it's a bit easier to understand. We will look at the overall energy for the month of July, for the sign of Gemini, before we then go into your emotional core, see if there's healing that needs to be happening or there's love coming in, that sort of stuff. Before we then lastly look at the, at opportunities as to present themselves to you in the month of July 2023. Now, I need to say this to you. We have the first of four supermoons happening, full moons, supermoons happening, which means the moon is closer to Earth, therefore your emotions are much more highlighted. You will feel much deeper, you will feel much more, and this will be happening on July 3rd. So the point I'm trying to make here is that the beginning of the months might feel very different to the rest of the months, and you would do well watching the full moon reading that you can also find on this channel. Really, really important. If you like, subscribe and share, you just click on the full moon reading for the month of July then, right? Really important not to underestimate this. Okay, so that said, let's look at the overall energy for the month of July for the sign of Gemini. Now, when it comes to your, or the overall energy for your sign, Geminis, this is not a month to do anything, sounds a bit weird, on your own, right? Don't hide, don't be the person that goes into a cocoon of thoughts. This is not the month to be super reflective, if that makes sense, and hide away from things, right? So we haven't even talked about your emotional core, see what's going on there. But with regards to your overall energy, you're supposed to be seen and supposed to be part of a community, right? And if you haven't found your tribe, then that is another job that you can look at this month, right? Where am I in the scheme of things? If you find that you're the only spiritual person in a 1500 kilometer radius and there's nobody around you, right, then it's time to Google, you know, what circles are there in your vicinity and just start anew, right? So see what I mean? But be part of the community. That is the overall energy for Gemini. Be part of something. Don't hide away. Okay, so, and now we're looking at your emotional core. Let's see what's happening there. Interesting. You haven't got much to do when it comes to your emotional core. Like I said, watch the supermoon reading, understand that you can do a lot about how you truly feel and reflect about a lot that you, how you feel when you understand how the energies flow when the supermoon hits on July 3rd. Your job for the entirety of July, when it comes to how you truly feel about things, is to remain grounded and to feel rooted. Anyone trying to upset you, tell them to piss off. Might not be your strength, Gemini, but you understand that. You allow people to invade your energy, you will have to deal with it. When you're rooted, when you're grounded, I mean, it's like I'm like a tree, right? I'm steadfast. I know who I am. With that energy, you will find it much easier to convey to others not to mess with you this month. Okay? So when it comes to your emotions, therefore, this is about understanding, no matter what life throws at you, remove yourself a little. See it from, yeah, okay. Right? I'm looking at this from a sort of semi-detached point of view. It will serve you better. Okay? So that was that, and now we're looking at the opportunities as they present themselves to you in the month of July. You are watching Thomas the Tarot Readings. Please like, subscribe, and share. And as I said, if you like my work, you can now buy me a coffee on buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. That's buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. Now, when it comes to opportunities, which is sort of what sustains you financially as well, in order for you to make any headway with manifesting what is for you, you need to understand that you are on a journey. Anywhere at this point in time that you feel, I've been doing this for years, the moment you feel, I'm a bit stuck here, you are correct and you should not be stuck. The energy here flows into this life is a journey. So maybe it's time I look into the next step. At the same time, a journey is not a marathon. The guides are not asking you to rush anything, right? Or to even be anxious about anything. Just understand, reflect on where am I at this point in time and how long have I been in that situation? And how long have I known that this energy doesn't really serve me? Because that's where you make the changes, understanding your self-worth. When you say like, no, I wouldn't send my best friend here, right? That's how you then manifest much better opportunities that are more geared towards who you truly are. Excuse me. Okay, and that's all I got for you this month. Thanks for hanging out with me. Please like, subscribe, and share. Don't forget to watch the full moon reading, because it is very important to watch this, because in the beginning of the month, there is an extra oomph to your emotions, right? And I see you all next month. Bye-bye.